So we now know the name of the attacker. It is 20-year Usman Khan, who was out on license. He's had been convicted of terrorism offences. One of the plots that he had done back in 2012 and been convicted for in indeterminate sentence was to try and blow up the stock exchange here in London. In the event, he was given a 16-year sentence, which was reduced to 8. He's been out since December 2018. He then asked to be released, and we understand that the agreement was that he would have an electronic tag, which from some photos he seemed to have been wearing. Now, what is worrying about this is that, in fact, the authorities then should have been controlling, monitoring him. He should have reported regularly to the police. And one of the key lines of inquiry will be very much looking at whether this was done and in what way. We know that this incident, major incident, terrorist incident, began around 2 p.m. near London Bridge in a place called Fishmongers Hall. He was attending, in fact, a rehabilitation program or conference called Learning Together, and it is during that he started stabbing people. Now, the death toll is he was neutralized after initially being detained and pinned to the ground on London Bridge by passers-by using sticks, and who managed to disarm him. The armed police unit was deployed quite quickly, within 5 minutes of the initial call, and then the police shot him. It was 2 shots. He was killed. Alas, we learnt last night that 2 members of the public who had been stabbed have also died, and we know that 3 people have been injured.
Now, Benedict, we've seen a lot of reactions from politicians on both sides of the aisle. What are the implications of this attack on the upcoming elections in the UK?
Well, that's right. We are in a campaign, electoral campaign. There is, on the 12th of December, a snap general election, and the politicians were campaigning yesterday, but both the government's Conservative Party and also the Labour Party, along with the Liberal Democrats, decided to suspend their campaign. Now, I understand some election events will be cancelled also today. We know also that there was a Cobra meeting, an emergency meeting, chaired by the Prime Minister last night. And Scotland Yard here behind me will be very much leading this investigation. We understand that there has been some activity in Staffordshire at the home of Usman Khan, and that is where he is believed to have lived. And of course, what the authorities will be assessing all the time is there a wider threat? It is not believed there is a wider threat, but nevertheless, in order to reassure Londoners and people visiting London, there are extra patrols that are planned throughout the weekend. Of course, a busy weekend in the lead up to Christmas, and in this particular context of a general election campaign, and also days away from that Tuesday and Wednesday 70th anniversary NATO summit here in London, where we expect major world leaders, including the American President Donald Trump, the French President Emmanuel Macron, and others.
Thank you very much. That's Benedict Pevio reporting there for us from London.